This is Lenny Farlee, Purdue University Extension Forester. Now let's ID that tree. On this edition of ID That Tree, we're going to introduce you to an Indiana maple species that may not suggest maple to you when you see the leaves, and that is Boxelder. And in fact, even the name suggests some folks decided maybe it didn't really belong in the maple group. But in fact, it is a member of our maple family here in Indiana. Boxelder has opposite leaf arrangement, just like all of our other native Indiana maples. What sets it apart are these compound leaves. And so Boxelder typically has 3 to 5 leaflets. And in fact, the 3-leaflet leaves can make a little bit of a suggestion of poison ivy. But remember, poison ivy has alternate leaf arrangement and is a vine typically. Boxelder, tree size, opposite leaf arrangement. Another good identification characteristic for Boxelder are these green twigs. And so this can be a bright kind of Kelly green or more of an olive green in color, but very typical for the species and not found on any of other native Indiana maples. Boxelder bark, as you can see, is kind of a medium gray in color, long running, relatively flattened ridges up and down. And this species is actually in flower right now. As you can see, not a particularly showy flower, long strands holding the pollen, relatively green to yellow green in color, and could even be missed if we're not looking closely. And that's oftentimes the case with many of our hardwood species. It may not have showy flowers, but they're flowering nonetheless to produce that fruit that reproduces the species. And as in the maples, this will ultimately produce a paired wing seed that we recognize floating across the landscape to reseed our maples. So Boxelder, fairly common denizen of some of our bottom and forest areas and wet and moist sites, and one of our native Indiana maples, but the only one with compound leaves.